Oh, ho, ho.
What a mysterious book this is, Le Casotan.
What was that? Was that French?
Yes.
That's not French. It's
Merci.
Merci, that's all right. That's French.
Well, what do you think you're doing? Oh,
ho, ho, ho. Oh, ho, ho. That's French.
Where's your beret, mate?
Well, we're in a little French sort of feel vibe,
that
here,
is
aren't we?
Because Nina George has done it again.
She
is German, but she wrote the most beautiful French yarns.
Yes, her very popular book, The Little Paris Bookshop, that was hit back in 2015, I think, wasn't it?
Yeah, 8 or so years ago. And it was a beautiful tale of a man who used books. You know how much, like, we read books for different reasons, right?
Yes.
Sometimes we read them to be informed, sometimes we read them
to escape.
And sometimes, you know me, I'm often hugging a book. When I really love it, I hug it.
You're a hugger.
So, I am. But we all have books that kind of sit with us, and that was a beautiful tale about books and the impact they can have on your life. And this is a different story, but along a similar vein.
It's not connected, but it sort of is connected to her first book as well. So
it's about the love of books, but also loves in your life.
It follows a young girl,
Marie-Jean.
Marie-Jean, who has this bit of a gift. So it's a bit of a fantasy element to this book, because she has a gift, so she can see bright sparks on people's faces, and when they come closer together...
And what are those sparkles?
The sparkles of love.
Yeah.
Because when they come closer together, when people who randomly have never met before, their sparks in their face glow.
Look at his face, it's sparking right now.
She's the only one that can see this and has this gift. So she becomes a bit of a matchmaker. So she goes around all these little towns.
Beautiful villages.
It's set in the 60s in these beautiful little French villages, sets up a mobile library with her foster father and goes around and basically plays matchmaker. Now, the only downside is she doesn't have this spark for herself. So she's trying to find a matchmaker for herself.
She wants some sparkles on her own face.
The relation to the books is that every time that she matches someone together, there is a book involved as well.
Yeah, and I kind of love that, because I think we all do have books in our life that remind us of a time or a place or a person. It's a story you can relate to, even though it's not a real story.
And this is interesting, because there's an olive tree, which is a character, love is a character, death is a character, so there's all these different characters in there as well. So unlike the normal sort of, you know, protagonist, which is an actual human being.
Yeah. So I think fans of Nina George's, they will like having something else. When you've loved a book, it's also nice to have another little strand or a thread as well you can keep.
The way that she describes these little French villages, they're real in real life.
Traveling?
I think you'll find that when people read this, they'll be booking trips to these little French villages as well.
Imagine going on the trail and having your book with you and ticking them off.
Yeah.
And guess what, Lee Castledine?
I reckon the book is available to be purchased online or in store today.
With your croissant.
Oui, oui.